some additional people signed up toward the end. Look at this nice Saturday afternoon, full house we have. It's lovely to see you all.
It really is. It's great to see all your faces. You all look like
this is a gift that you've given us because you made us practice. It kind of goes like this. John, I can't read this classical crap. Barb, you jazzers are making it up as you go along. John, well, I'll play my part and you play your part. And we've gotten really good at it. We've got a lot of variety for you today. We really tried to pick a lot of different things from different cultures and styles to show you all the different things that you can do with a piano, a viola, and a flute.
Or two pianos.
So the next piece, of course, that was Ain't Misbehaving by Fats Waller, a classical tune. We got more of that coming from those that were singing and stopping or whatever it is you're doing. The next piece is an interesting piece. It's from the Disney movie Sleeping Beauty, actually Snow White. It's Someday My Prince Will Come. And what's neat about this tune is it's a waltz. And you can play it classical style. But then in the 50s, Bill Evans started playing a jazz style, and Miles Davis took it. Before you knew it, it became a jazz classical thing. His music is so pure that you can put almost any instrument behind it, and it sounds like it was written for those instruments. This was written for one pianist to play, and some of you have played it. This is the Bach two-part invention in E minor. but we're going to play it with flute and viola.
Well, and this arrangement was for violin instead of flute and viola, so we went even farther.
Oh.
For those of you hoity-toities, it's number 13 in A minor. Don't you love it? Don't you love it on KFM when they take, well, I'm listening to the D minor symphony. I'm like, who cares? Well, it's much better than the C minor. He really advanced.
What's the curve in listening?
This is the one.
Yeah, this is fairly popular. But it's fun. We had a lot of weird deals, so it's fun. Song of Barb's brother Bob, and he's a bassist. He recently had a family reunion with Barb's family. There were 30 of them down in Portland. It's a beautiful event. She has three sisters and one brother, five siblings. And Bob made us borrow a bass so he could practice with us. And then he drove up down to Portland and he borrowed another bass. And he's working. And we're trying to keep it a surprise from her sister, who's like, you know, really smart. So like. We managed to get everything stuffed into the room before everybody showed up, and we played the event, and it was really fun. Bob was just in his glory. This is one of his favorite tunes, so we're playing this in honor of Bob making us practice more. So this is A Child Is Born by Thad Jones. Mm-hmm.
Rochester, Minnesota. And we just, I happened to find the most glorious bit of what the organ master, the organ and the choir master, the choir director, music director, the whole thing, was a guy named Orvis Ross. I've played his pieces many a time here. Thanks, Millie. I want to speak out so you all can hear. My family got to know him. He was just a lovely human being, and he composed all the time. It was what drove him. And he taught a lot of lessons, and he had the choir, and blah, blah, blah. So I got to grow up. We didn't play recitals. We played in church. You know, we didn't have those formal recitals that were so awful, as I recall. That could be so awful. Not always, but anyway. And it turned out, I started studying with him when I was just 7 years old. And I was the third in the family, so he already knew the older two. They took piano lessons too. And we happened, Orvis and I, to have the same birthday. So starting when I was seven, when I just had turned eight, a few months after I started with him, he turned whatever age, and I turned eight. And so he wrote this little piece for me based on something he'd already composed for children's choir. It was called Sing a Song for Christmas. And if you remember just this little bit. Okay. So it's really a privilege to play this, and I imagine that he's around. 16 pieces for me through my wedding. And then there was a long hiatus, and I didn't expect to hear from him again. I knew he was not doing well, and I didn't expect to hear anything, but I did get one last piece that I'll play at church sometime. It's called At Morn, M-O-R-N, M-O-U-R-N, At Morn, and it was composed the year before he died, and he was in his 80s when he died, so. So, you know, he was a lifelong friend and a very important influence on all of us. Reminiscence, December 14th, 1955. I'm just learning what this thing is.
So Barb is just gotten what's known as a pickup on her instrument, which amplifies it. So now she's got a new friend, the chord. Act of bravery that you're watching here for Ruth.
Where does this go? I have to have it this way.
Okay. We should show you later what it sounds like without it. You'd be amazed that it really adds body to the room. Without giving out here.
Thank you.
church and sang tenor and played as well, and so it was all in the family. And he got me this music that I didn't really appreciate much then. It was it's by a Belgian composer of the 20th century. He was an organist and very religious human being. And when I went online, I just Googled him to see. And this piece came up as his, you know, the piece de resistance, something. You know, like everybody played it. Now, we didn't like the tempo, but, you know, that's okay. and so this is a very pensive, inward-looking piece. And it's both, say something about
the harmonic. Yeah, the interesting thing about this piece, there's a lot of music, once Gershwin and all the other jazzers penetrated American popular music, a lot of those chords, you know, these jazz chords started to penetrate compositions of sort of popular composers in American music. So this has some interesting moments when it almost sounds like jazz, moments when it almost sounds like classical, and other moments when it just sounds like an American tune. So it's kind of a nice mix of stuff by the European. So it's called Aria. State Fair, Jim Crane leans out the window singing this beautiful love ballad, which the Boston of the Jazz, which could be turned into an up-tempo jam. So nothing to do with that ballad thing. This is a beautiful song, actually was popularized in the Boston of the craze. It might as well be spring.